Hey guys, what's going on? It's Christopher's here, Mikey Oster here, and today we have another custom minifigure showcase, yay! Some quick little updates. First off, there's two ideas, plans, thoughts videos out today that should be uploaded by now, and yeah. Also, there will be two more minifigure showcases, custom minifigure showcases. One is a group of figures that I upgraded, so yeah. And another one is on a Korra figure, and yeah. And speaking of Korra figures, I have finished Korra from Series 3 Customs. I've also finished Mako, and I will be working on more of them soon. And as soon as Series 2 is done, we're going to launch right into that, because I've got some building up already, so that's good. And yeah, I'm really excited for this series. It's going to have a lot of awesome figures. And it's good to get back to some of the main characters on, like, last, series. And, yeah, it's gonna be awesome. And also today there will be a Pirates of the Shipwreck Episode 3. So, yeah, there's also a possibility of, VA Pyre and maybe a movie. I'm not sure yet. It's possible. But, yeah. Alright, and today we have the Sniper from Team Fortress 2. Aw, yeah. So, I really like making these Team Fortress 2 figures, and I'll continue to make them. I'll make every single class, and there's a slight possibility that I might make the other colors too, like a Blue Sniper, Blue Scout, etc. And yeah, that probably won't be for a while now, but it's a possibility. And yeah, so let's take a look at this figure. So we're going to start off with his accessories. So he's got two of them. He's got this knife. Really cool, it looks a lot like one of his knives. I don't remember the name of it, but it's the same shape. Pretty cool. It is a Brick Forge custom, and I will try to find it on the website and put the link in the description below so you guys can check that out. And we also have his compound bow. Now, I didn't make his sniper because I figured the bow would be a lot easier to make, and it was true, it was. And this is from, you can get this from numerous sets, such as the new Dark Side Invasion. Green Arrow has this, but of course it's green, not black. And you can get this from Hawkeye and the Avengers sets. And you can also get this in the Hunter from Series 12, I believe. And yeah, really cool. I painted it. We've got the string is painted a kind of tan, I guess. And the arrow itself is painted brown with white detailing on the arrow head and the feathers. Pretty cool. I believe this is fairly accurate to its compound bow in the game. And yeah, let's take a look at the arrow holder, the quiver. Now it is painted tan, and it's got the brown arrows in there, of course, with the white feather detailing. And yeah, let's take a look at the actual figure now. So here are his pants. As you see, he's got some shoes on. They're kind of hard to see, but in off camera, they're actually a little easier to see, probably because of the lighting. And he's got a little pouch on the side, which is also really hard to see. Sorry about that. But it is actually there, because he has a pouch there with numerous items. And here is his torso, which is my favorite part of this figure. As you see, he has his vest on, which continues on to the legs a little bit. And he's got some pockets, he's got the strap for the quiver, he's got some bullets in that pocket, and two different colors, of course, which obviously continues on the back, but I'm not going to show that because the quiver is covering it up. It's just pretty plain on the back. And yeah. On this side, we have a flesh part right here for his exposed skin, because he's got kind of like a short sleeve on. And he's got his symbol right there. It's not actually his symbol, because that is pretty hard to paint, so I just did that. And of course, oh, he's got red on. And let's take a look at his head and his hat. So this is a hat from Johnny Thunder. If you don't know who that is, it's this Explorer guy. And he's in a lot of old sets, the Adventure line, which is kind of old. I think it came out in the 90s. And he is also in a new LEGO movie set. I don't remember which one it is. It's from last year, though. So, yeah. You're getting pretty cheap on Bricklink, too, if you're looking for him. And, yeah, so here is his face. Now, this is actually painted. Most of them I like to go with the purest head, where I don't really mess it up, because I find, like, the perfect head. But I didn't really find the perfect head for this guy. Same with the engineer, so I'm probably going to have to do that. But, anyways, so it was a Superman head originally. If you noticed on the back, you saw the other head. I didn't mean to, yeah. But he's got sideburns, of course, patented sideburns, and his glasses, of course, are painted on. They're not the greatest, but I think it turned out pretty good. Not the best, but still pretty good. First time really painted glasses, I think. And he's got yellow tinted glasses. Just like in the game. Now, I use Sharpie with this because there's no real other way of doing it. So, yeah. And, yeah, that's about it. Thank you guys for watching. Let me know what you thought of this figure. And there will be another Team Fortress 2 custom coming up next week. And, yeah. Coming to an end pretty soon. We've got a couple more classes to do. I believe four more. And, yeah. I'll see you guys in the next video. Oh yeah, it's me, Mikey, yay! Bye! I'm sure most of you stay around to the end because you guys already know that I'm going to show off the next figure for next week, just like a quick little glimpse. So here we go. Next week is the Soldier, yeah. Alright, that's it. Bye-bye! Oh, wait, hold on, you wanted more? Alright, so the week after the Soldier will be the Demo Man. Not done yet, I haven't even started him yet, but I will soon. And also, one more thing. Boba Fett, ladies and gentlemen. Boba Fett.